I'm Denis Kudriashov. By incident, I create new Pharo browser, and this is a presentation about new Pharo browser, which named Calypso. So the funny things is a few slides, which Stefan Dukos made for this presentation. So this is a picture of how Steph think Nautilus looks. Nautilus is a default browser. So it sees many strange creatures, monsters. And the next picture is how it should, how this browser should look like. So this is actually the ship of Cousteau. Yes. And in the ship of this clever guy Cousteau, there were many nice tooling small ships. And now let's. And now I will show what Calypso brings. First, I want to say that when I start to use Nautilus, I always miss a lot of things, and I think in the past it was OmniBrowser, which was previous browser in the Pharo, was much better, and we miss many features when we move to the Nautilus. And now with Calypso, I try to recover what was missing for me all the time. And this is what I want to show.
And more, wait.
Yeah, yes,
this,
and
this
more.
Is much better than from the browser, huh? So.
So, first thing that new browsers, every table new browser uses a new fast table component in Pharo, which provides very fast view on the large list, because it builds user elements only for visible lists, visible part of lists. Another nice thing with new browser is a multiple selection everywhere. So you are able to select multiple packages, and you will see all classes in these packages. You are able to select multiple classes. You will see all protocols composed from both classes and all methods together. And very, very nice feature is the automatic selection when you switch between classes. For example, so here I should show it in life.
Yeah. Switch up to 10, 24 times 86 on that screen.
What I don't understand why it is not showing the screen. Anybody has experience with it? Ah, it's now works.
Easiest would be to change your arrangement to not mirror, and then you'll be seeing exactly what's happening.
Yes.
You click on the tab on the top. Just increase the scale. So yeah, the feature which I want to show is automatic reselection. So for example, if you go, if you select initialize method and we go to another class which has initialize method, then it will be selected automatically. Yes. And that's pretty useful feature. And in fact, it is works in any other places. So if you go to another package, so there is no class which was before, and you go back again, and class immediately reselected to this method. And if you select multiple packages, it will still be selected, so nothing is reset. Another difference from the current browser is that it is now not single source pane. It is multiple tools which are driven by tab manager, and it can be extended with more tools with the browser plugin. So, for example, not yet example. This tab manager allows to select multiple tabs together to see everything in once. And when we switch, so when we select multiple tabs and switch to another class, it will still show both tabs. It also needs to be shown in live. So for example, I can select comment together with method, and then if I go to another method, comment will be still here, and I can of course select also the class definition, and everything continue working. Okay, now I show what exact separate tools we have. So we have separate class creation tool, which knows that user wants to create new class on selected package, or package can be not selected, it is not important. There is separate class editor tool, which activated when you select the class. This tool knows that now we select concrete class. The idea of this separation is actually, not idea, but just this approach simplify a lot of code in this tool, because when we know what we do, we don't need a lot of branches in the code. I mean, if true, if false conditions. There is separate class comment tool, and there is separate method creation tool, which is nice. I think it is very nice to use this, because when user first time looked in the small talk in general, he didn't have any feedback how to create new method, and here it is explicitly class inside method. If you will be on the class side, it will be class side method, and you can immediately start to create new class without creation protocols. And if you see in this tool, there is also in place protocol editor, so you don't need to create protocol and method protocols. You just type name here, and when you will accept changes, protocol will be created. And it also allows you to create new package extension. So if you want to create new method as extension, you just press this checkbox, it will request you to select package, and you will done. And when you select method, then method editor tool is activated. And again, like this class creation, class editor, it is also separation very important, because it's allowed to provide a bit specific logic and avoid some kind of branch condition in the logic where we implement method editing.
Show a slide.
I just continue with other features. And method editor, like in Nautilus, allow quality assistant. It's also integrated here. Yes. And if you look into the light. So if we go to some class, if I remove selection, so I can create methods in the new category, like new protocol. So it's new protocol is created and it is highlighted. And if you want to create, and we can move methods to another protocol just from here. Protocol 2. So we don't need to go to the context menu of protocols view. Yes, of course, you can drag and drop just to here, it is all supported. It is not updated yet. And we can, of course, just move to extension methods from here. So we can go to the help. And it is now. After this, I need to commit changes, accept changes. And now we can see that. Next slide will show that you now cannot afraid to go to another place in the system when you are in editing. So if you try to implement some logic, you want to show, I want to look in some other place, you can just go to another method, for example. No problem, your editing session is still here, and you can return here. And now also you see that it shows in the bottom, it shows that context of this method is actually different. I will show you it's better in other place, because here it's just different context, but it's still the same class. And different context here means that we select another method. And we can just go back to the method, and we'll be still here. And interesting thing, how browser interact with the changes. So what should happen if we move the, let's go to the non-set 2 to not corrupt the system. What happen if I move? What happen if I move a non-set 2 to another page? What should happen with my editing session with all these tasks? Because probably I open it because I want to look at this code. But then I can open another browser and decide to move to repackage the class. So I can do it from this same browser. So what happens if I drag and drop to another package? You see, the selected package is still same, but because we move class to another package, it's not anymore present in the class list. But all tabs are still here, but they indicate that the context of browser is now different than what's shown in the methods. And here we can actually press this button to go to move browser to actual place of editing method. And now we see the actual place where method and class is now defined. So yeah, this is what I show. And another tab is method diff, which activated when we select multiple methods, two methods. Probably it will be changed in the future because maybe it is not the best default behavior when we select two methods.
Yeah, because we could, instead of showing the diff, we can show two methods.
Yeah, that's the idea. When you select three or four methods, it can actually add four tabs and show them together.
So this means that we can edit multiple methods at the same time. I have a really big brain, I can do it. So, yes.
Another interesting new thing in this browser is extendable status bar. There was status bar in the Nautilus, but problem that it was implemented with status bar rubric editor, which is just text editor, which is strange because it can be filled with other items, but it is part of text editor. And here it is just separate two, so there is no relation to text, and the browser can extend this status bar depending on selected context or depending on the tool and fill it with new items. For example, in this picture you see that there is critic analysis, so critic plugin of Calypso extends status bar to show indication of critic computation. And also there is another place of extensibility is the tools which are bound to selected tab. Now this part is filled by navigation buttons and some method history view. Another tab with method history is not exist. And the traditional middle panel is again back in the browser, and it is extensible. So we again have senders and implementers, and also class references, which is very suitable. And items of this toolbar can be extended by plugins. And we have now a new type of hierarchy. So if we long time we have trains, but they never be really good integrated in the browser. Now we at least able to browse the hierarchy according to the trains. So we can see what current selected trait or class, what trait it used. And we can see who uses selected trait. And also there is another interesting mode when we select two classes and switch to hierarchy. Then browser will show hierarchy, composed hierarchy of both classes. It can be very useful when you want to analyze general hierarchy of multiple classes. Also in Calypso, there is new mode of method protocol view, which allows to see all variables which are accessible from the class, which are visible from the class. And when we select the variable, it shows what method uses it. And we able to refactor, now we able to refactor variables just from the context menu of variable. Yes, and interesting feature is navigation history. That in Calypso navigation history affects not record not only change of selected items in the table, but also switches between mode, which we show between hierarchy, and I show it in life. For example, we can of course go back and forward just to the selection. But it's interesting that we can switch to hierarchy and still go to the back. And there is shortcut, command arrow, not command, option arrow, which works here. And also it is works to go back from the variables to methods. And also it is works on the expansion of something. Okay, there is some easy. And very important part of the new browser is that there was old idea of dynamic protocols. It was available in many small talk dialects, but sadly, I think it was died in all of them. It is not accessible anymore in other systems. And Calypso recovers this, and it is implemented just by design as a part of method groups. So in fact, this third pane of the browser is not protocol view, but method group view. And when user select the class, browser collect method groups from all installed plugins. And first interesting method group is inherited method, which allow to switch visibility of methods. So it provide, for example, it provide suitable checkbox to show all inherited methods up to object, because object is not really interesting. And it provides a special checkbox to show all traits which are inherited by a selected class. And of course, from the expanded items, user can select just content superclass to see method, its inherited method together with selected class methods. Next method group is extensions. We just show the packages which extend the class. And now the old
dynamic protocol, so we're able to see all abstract methods of selected class, all the writing methods which overrides some superclass methods, and methods which should be implemented. So we select all methods from the superclass here, which are abstract. So this group actually made, there is a refactoring realized class. I don't know if it exists in other small talks, I think yes. But this group made it useless because it just shows what should be implemented and you can define it just in the selected method. There is also a deprecated method group which shows all deprecations. There is breakpoints, which shows all methods where breakpoints are started. It supports height expression and also metalink driving breakpoints. And there is critic method group which collects all problem methods in the group. So you are able to see what methods need some attention, what have problems according to all defined rules in the system. So this is integrated with what Yuri Dinchuk shows in his presentation. And also when you expand package, you see also class groups which are similar to method groups, and they also extendable by plugins, and they are similar to dynamic method protocols. So right now implemented only extensions class group, which shows all classes which are extended by this package. Okay, this is some nice another slide. Now I will show the method browser which works on the same model like Calypso. So method browser, you also see same evidence like only one table of methods, then toolbar, same like in Calypso but extended with different elements, and same tabs. And in Calypso method browser, you now see same method icons which present in the full system browser, which was not available before. There is a special tool to filter method according to the scope of spawning browser. So if we open, it's better to show in white. So imagine that we open initialize centers of initialize, then look that we now spawn this browser from the nonce query and the nonce class. So which means that method browser will see filtered scopes, will have filtered scopes from this browser. So we can see what other centers exist in the package from the system browser. We can switch. Or we can see from the full announcement here who sent initialize method. And also this tool shows the extra scope of current selected methods. So you see that it shows scope of selected method package and selected method class. And we can switch it. And navigation, of course, working here too.
Denis, what? Can you redo what you did before? Because
I switch here.
Yes.
And then I can switch to just announcer. Scope of announcer class.
Yes.
What?
And then you mentioned the package and I couldn't understand.
The package? We can see the senders in the scope of package of system browser, as I said. And we can see the senders in the scope of the package of selected method. So here selected, here it is not interesting. So I go in some other place. Here we see that there is selected classes, kick, dialog, window class, and we can switch to the scope of selected class. And we show you see only this one. That's the idea.
Okay.
And the navigation is working here same way, so we can go back and forward. And also method browser provides a way to switch between hierarchical view, which will show methods sorted by class hierarchy, using class hierarchy. And also it is recorded by navigation history. Okay. This is what I showed. Yeah, also switching to concrete scope can be accessed by context menu. Yes, an interesting feature that when you produce a subsequent query from the method browser, then it's actually open a new tab in current window instead of new window. This should decrease the number of open windows during navigation. And navigation back from the spawning method query will close current window, and navigation back will restore it. For example, if I go to the class users of SDL class, if I press, yeah, so here you see that we see references, and I go back and the window will disappear, and then I can go forward and window will be open again. And in fact it is not just in the tab, it is supported across window, which is very cool. So if I go back, I made too many navigations, so it's better to show like this. So yes, I can go back and forward across windows, which can be very suitable. And there is this unique plugin which extends the toolbar of method browser to run all tests which are available on this method list. And it also shows the all failed tests and makes possible to run all of them. And as unique plugin extends the browser also with extra tab which shows all the setup method. So it allows you to see in what environment it's working. And it's also a new way to create setup very easily, because if there is no special setup in class, it will show just superclass empty setup method which you can edit directly here. And same tab exists in system browser. And another extension from this unit plugin is a special group of failed tests. So as soon as test failed, this group is appears and you can browse all failed tests together. That's all features, current features. Yes, what is missing, you can, so if you will try to use it, you can record it in GitHub page. Probably there is some missing comments and refactorings, and I'm sure we can have, we will implement many new ideas with this browser, because there is a lot of possibilities. Questions?
It's not a really question, but I want to congratulate you for this result, because I expected it for, I've been expecting it for more than 20 years, because as developers, we tend to implement things that are easy to implement, but not those that are really needed. So it's easy to implement an editor for a single method in one class. It's more that you okay, edit this method, save, and done, and select the next method. That's easy to implement. That was what I found in almost all small implementations, the only way to edit. But my process, when I edit, I start with one method, send something that might be new, then I would like to start with this new method somewhere else, then develop a new idea, okay, set another new selector, implement this, but want to see all of the three methods. And this was almost impossible without opening different browser windows all the time and never making a big mistake by something, because then it asks you save, save, save. Because, and this is the real progress I see. I was almost 10 times at the edge of developing an own browser for my work. But now I hope it's done. Thank you.
Thank you. There is also an interesting idea how to improve new class creation. Because right now, if you try to remember how you do it, then usually you create a class and then you need to create you add some instance variable and you create, and then you need to create a constructor of class from the class side. Then you need to switch to class side, then to create protocol on class side instance creation, then to create method, and then you remember that you actually not implement accessors, and you go back and implement accessors, or open context menu, generate accessor, and so on. I think it can be just done with one tool, create constructor.
Further on that idea, have you, you have a workflow that people could customize so that, because you're defining a workflow that says, I'll edit this method, I'll edit this method, I'll edit this method, which is fantastic. But we may, as we do working, you have a workflow behind, if you could pull that out so it becomes a workflow that people could customize, then you would really be going the next step. Well, it's a question, but could you do it? Can you do it? Is your workflow open so that you can do that? Or is it just in methods the way we normally code? But if you could have the workflow as separate objects with the flow, and then we could allow a person to define different flows for how they want to work in this given situation.
I think to implement new workflow, you need to implement new browser. And yes, Calypso has some model to implement new browser. That's why there is system browser, method browser. There is also initial implementation of process browser. So in the browser, you define the user transition between the data. And you can extend. I will show in the next part of session how to extend.
How does your brother or brothers relate to the Lambda's toolkit? Or are they supposed to be separate browsers for separate workflows or applications?
So Calypso is not general browser framework. So that's a difference, and it's just implemented in Morphic. So it is not provide some special page made independent from the user level. So it is Morphic based. But if you ask me how to move this browser to the block, then probably it should be not difficult if the block will provide table widget, tab widgets, or some several set of widgets, then it should be just a question to change superclass and maybe to change some API, but it should be not difficult.
Yeah, but still you have two browsers. So is one replacing the other, or is it the future plan to have two or more browsers?
Two browsers, you mean non-tables?
No. So, there are also browsers in here.
It does not have a browser yet.
Oh, okay. We know that.
That's a picture for Jack Thomas. So, we can have that.
Okay.
So, then I will continue with the internal details of Calypso model, which should be interesting. It will be next.
There are two talks.
Yeah, because I have two talks.
But you are half an hour
late. I have to make it in the time. I don't need to make it in the time. So under hood, Calypso provides some navigation model, which allows to query to execute queries over our system environment. So as soon as we want to retrieve classes or methods or packages, we need some place where we will retrieve it. So
In Calypso model is first class scope, this place where we look at systems. So there is explicit package scope, explicit class scope, method scope, there is also default global system scope. And first step to start navigation is to retrieve scope from some root navigation environment with this API. And then with scope you can execute some queries. And queries also modeled in the Calypso with first class objects. So for example, there is first class message senders and class references. And to execute query, you just need to add scope to query for the query instance. And the result of query is also represented by first class object. So there is why it is needed, because in some cases we want, for example, retrieve all classes from package in the sorted order, just basic sorted order, or in the hierarchically sorted order. And that's how we define in the package what we actually to do. We create a query with concrete type of results which we want to retrieve. And there is a simple way to query system just by using this concrete type of results, because usually concrete type of result knows default query which can use it. Another part of model is that actual result of query execution represented by cursor instance. It is similar to how database usually model query execution. So cursor provides a way to for the stream access to the underlying query items. It cache portion of items and load new portion only by demand. And it is important for the remote browsing. So generally Calypso was started because I was needed to implement remote browser. And the remote browser problem that when we show hierarchical classes, in classic browsers, this hierarchy is built in the UI part. But in the remote scenario, it is not working because it can be a long list of classes, and building hierarchy on the client will lead to a lot of communication if you drive it with some transparent network. And in Calypso, Calypso result built it on the server, and cursor with cached items transferred to the client. And that's how fast table with Calypso show only retrieve from server only visible part of objects. But interesting that in the local environment it actually also makes sense for this cache. Because imagine that in browser we mark abstract classes with special property or with special font, italic font or with special item that it is abstract. And to realize this, we need to ask class, is it abstract or not? Which inside will iterate over hierarchy analysis methods. And it is very expensive to build these properties for the all classes which we retrieve. So in the cursor model, Calypso resolve all properties of items only for the requested part of items. So only for visible part in the browser, all these possible properties will be built. And properties extended by plugins. And also cursor provides some subsequent query API, which allows to reevaluate original query, but with specific difference. So in the specific difference scope, for example, in the scope of extra package, or without some existing package of current scope, or regulate query by representing result with different way, so from the sorted to the hierarchical view, and many other different ways. And an important point of all this navigation model, the cursor encapsulates the main navigation state of browser. So it knows what kind of query it represents, and this is how browser distinguish method group mode and variable mode. The scope, cursor knows in what scope result is shown, and that is how browser distinguish between instance side and class side.
And also, it is how browser show inherited method visibility, toggle inherited method visibility. In fact, when you select some superclass, which method you want to see together with selected class, the current query of method just re-evaluated with extra class in the class call. And also Cursor knows about what kind of result it presents, and this is how in method browser we can switch between flat method and hierarchical method. We just use current Cursor and ask it to re-evaluate query with different result type. So this provides the way to implement browser without a lot of special flux like in all browsers, and remove a lot of branches like if true and false to understand what is going on. And last point in navigation module is what is actual result items. So when you evaluate query and ask for sort for items, it's actually not classes or methods. Special environment items which provide actual object like classes and methods and extend them with properties. And these items provide information about position inside query result, about depth inside query, inside built here or here, and provide extended domain specific properties. And idea is that you can extend browser with special environment plugins which can provide more properties to the environment item. That's how SUnit plugin extend items with the test result. So I tried to go more faster without the demo about this model.
No, because the demo you already gave it.
Yeah. Like that. I just can show you in the...
Denis, seriously, I think that in 10 minutes we should start the other session.
Yeah, okay. So this is general... What I explained is general model for the navigation in Calypso is provide a way to simplify implementation of browsers and to make browser work in remote scenario. And another part, so I will skip it. This is just an example how to open a fast table on the cursor. So a special data source was implemented for this. And on data source you can specify tree structure of the data. Here should be the demo, but I skip. In the browser also selection represented not just by indexes but by first class objects. So there is data selection, which includes manually selected items. There is highlighting selection, which represents what highlights, and that's how highlighting, when you select methods, the method row are highlighted, which include it. And there is desired selection, which is possible to restore a selection when there is previously selected, when there is item which is similar to previously selected item. So this is how automatic reselection is working. And main responsibility of all this selection is to maintain correct state after any system changes. So if you select method and somebody remove method on the top of list, then selection will be valid, will be still valid and point to the right index in the list. And for navigation history, it is not really interesting. And the way how to extend browser. So first thing is a commons. So Calypso, based on the commander, which is the implementation of common pattern. In commander, you implement each possible command with a first class object, where you just define execute method with the logic. And then on the class side, you attach how to access this command from the application in specific context. And for example, here you see rename package command execute is quite trivial question. How to retrieve package and new name. And this logic is implemented in the special prepare full execution method, which can be packaged in the UI package and not in the domain package. So that here developer decide how to retrieve state in some kind of standard context of application which developers should think about. And then they decide in what concrete context instance comments should be activated. And then on the class side, you just define
how you want to access this command, and you can put this method, activator method, to the your own package, in your own application. And drag and drop is also a good example how to that command is actually very extendable. And if you want command to be executed by drag and drop, you just apply another kind of activator, drag and drop activator. But drag and drop needs two contexts. It needs context from where you start drag action, and context where you want to drop it. And then to prepare state of command in the context of drag and drop activation, you need two preparation logic. You need to prepare state when you start to drag, and you need to prepare state when you drop. Next accessibility is table decoration. So this is how icons on the method appears, and how the abstract classes are decorated with special form. So here you just need to implement subclass of table decorator. Again, you need to define like informs in what context it should be activated, and then business logic like to decorate table cell. And another way that actually most of icons on the method view are clickable, so it is in fact also common. And to add command to the table to be activated near the table cell, then you special kind of Calypso domain activator is implemented. So if you in the Calypso to add running to add button to the method list to run tests, you just need to apply special table icon activator to the test method form, and then add some UI specific method which will put icon to the item cell element. And another part is how to extend tabs. I already explained what the tabs exist. It's just very simple. So each tab represented by two, which in fact just morph. So in build method you implement, you fill this morph with required element, which probably some existing widgets show. It's very easy to add some widgets to the browser. You also define context where it should be used, like in other cases. And the last two things that we can extend method groups. For this we need to specify. For this we need to create environment plugin where we will define the group provider, and group provider should create required number of groups. For example, in abstract method, group provider analyze if method has subclass responsibility, and then creates abstract method group. And similar way working for class groups. So you just need to create in your plugin class group providers, which then will fill items with required set of groups. So that's all.
Then I continue with show as project because
yeah.